Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMI RPG and SQL sample video. In many programs, we have the need to insert a record into a table, or if it already exists, insert a new one. To do this, many of us do it checking the value of sqlcod. We do the update, and if it fails because the record does not exist, then we add a new record. There is a simpler and more elegant way to do this using the merge statement. Today, I show you an example of how to use it. Let's go. Well, we are in the run SQL scripts utility, and I'm going to show you the contents of the table that I'm going to play with. This is my table games. And as you see, I have four records. Also, I have to say that this table has a unique key on the ID field. Okay, we are going to use merge to do what I explained at the beginning of the video. For example, I will try to update a record in the table when the ID is 54, for example, and in that case I'm going to change the name of the game to game 99. For that, this is what I have to do: merge into, right here, the target table, okay, using here, I am indicating that I am going to use the merge statement on my table games. And for this, I'm going to use these values. In this case, I only indicate the value of the unique key of the record that I want to modify. But here, I could indicate more values of the record if in my table I don't have a unique key. Okay? Also, if you see, I'm giving a name to my target table and to my source table. The source table has only one record, that is the one indicated after the word using, this one. Okay, then we will see an example where I use something more complex. I'm also indicating that I want to perform the operation when the ID of the target table is the same as that of the source table. Well, after this, I have to write when not matched, then okay, and this means that when the record is not found, I'm going to insert a new record with these values. And if the record exists, then I'm going to change the field name to this with this value. Okay, well, let me run the statement. Okay, and as you see, one row is affected by the statement. And if I see the content of the table now, what I have is this. As you see, the record with the ID number 54 has changed the name to game 99. So merge has found a field with this ID, and as it has found it, then the merge has run this part of the statement, okay? Well, let me change this value to, for example, to 58, that it doesn't exist, okay? And if I run it, what I have is this. Okay, as it has not found it, what it has done is an insert in this case, okay? Well, as you can see, it has worked correctly. So as you see, this is a pretty good way, I think, more elegant to do inserts or updates in a single statement. Of course, you can, for example, change the update operation for a delete. Imagine that I want now that if merge found the ID number 58, I want to delete it. I can do this, and if I run it, now what I have in my table is this. So the last record has been removed, okay? Well, let's do this a little more complex. Imagine that we have a main table with many records and a temporary table with the same structure where there are some records. We want to go through the records of the temporary table, check if the record exists in the main table, in which case I will update the record with the data from the temporary table, and if it does not exist, we will insert the record from the temporary table in the main table. How would you normally do this? Well, it is a little complex, and yes, we can use merge for this, and it is very easy. Well, let me show you a main table that I have, that is this. Games 2. Okay, I have this main table, and also I have a temporary table with this name. Okay, normally you all have these tables into the Qtemp, but this is an example. Okay, well, as you see, there are records in the table games 1 that exists in the table games 2. When I'm saying exists, I mean that there's a record in the main table with the same ID. So here I have the ID 51 and 54, as in the games 2 table, 51 and 54, but the names are different, okay? Also, I have here the ID number 58 that doesn't exist in the main table. Well, what I want is that merge goes through the temporary table and insert or update each record according to the conditions we said before, okay? Well, in this case, this is what I have to write: merge into games 2, that is the target, using games 1 as the source, on target ID is source ID. Okay, let me move it. Okay, well, in this case, I'm defining the target table as games 2 and the source table as games 1. And I want merge to check the records that I have the same key in both tables, okay? Well, when both records matched, then we are going to update set name equal to source name, type equal to source type, okay, and if not, well, not matched, then in that case I will insert a new record with this information, name. Okay. Then That is, with this statement, which is only one statement, it is a little large, but it's only one statement, I'm going to do what I said before. I'm going to go through the table and I'm going to insert or update the records as appropriate. Let me run it. Okay. And if I see in my main table, this is what I have. I have inserted the record with the ID number 58, and also I have changed the ID number 51 and 54 with these two different names. Okay. Well, as you see, this is a very simple and elegant way to do this type of operations. Also, if you are used to doing these things using RPG directly, this way you will notice that it is much faster and easier, as I say, in a single statement. Well, I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.